Hello and welcome to TechSit Tutorials. Today I am going to start a brand new series on Angular. And this is the first video where we'll do a setup using Angular CLI. We will understand the project's file structure. We will look at the dependencies. We will build our first component and we will look at the test. And in the end, I will show you how to upload the project onto GitHub. And by the way, this will be a different kind of series where we work on a particular project and build functionality on top of it and learn in the process. And all the project code is going to be on the GitHub, so you can fork it, play around with it, make it yours, whatever you want to do. You will learn about Angular 4, GitHub, Git, TypeScript, package management, NPM, and command line interface. Bookmark this video by adding to your playlist so you can follow the entire series. And yes, I'll try to release one video every week, most probably Tuesday, so watch out for it. Alright, before we do anything, we need to install a right version of Node.js on our computer. To do that, we can go to nodejs.org and you can install the right version for your operating system. Now, if you already have a version installed on your computer, make sure that it's later than 6.9. And a way to check it, if I go on a console and type in node-v, and it should show me I have 6.11, which is later than 6.9, so I'm fine. And if you're having trouble installing because of the operating system or whatever reason, just message me and I'll help you. All right, so the next thing I want to do is install the Angular CLI. Since I have Node, I can use Node Package Manager and npm install.-g, and the library name is angular/CLI. Here, dash g means install the CLI globally, which means I can use it from any folder. If I run this, it will start installing. It takes about a few minutes, so be patient. Once it's installed, you can verify by simply type ng. And it should give you all the commands related to Angular CLI, so it's installed properly. Okay, now I'm gonna create my first app, but before I need to create a folder where all the ng app would live. So I'm going to say within the document, I'm just gonna put into the document, I'm gonna say kdir, and then the name of the folder is going to be learning Angular 4. And if I cd into it, and now I can, inside this, I can create my first app. So you can use the ng command, ng new, and then the name of the project. So I'm gonna call it my first ng app. And you wanna have a meaningful name. So again, it will take a few minutes to create it. All right, so now it's created. It says project my ng app successfully created. So it created a folder and created lots of files inside. So we need to go inside that folder. So I'm gonna cd into it, my first app. So once I'm inside it, before we look at this project, what's inside, let's just run it and see how it compiles. So for that, I'm just gonna say ng serve --, open. And what it will do, it will compile the project and open it in the browser on localhost. Okay, so here's a project on localhost on port 4200, which is default. And I have a welcome to app, some Angular logo, and there's three links. Now, this is a template application. When you create any app, this comes with it by default. And it can change. So just in case if you're seeing something else, that doesn't mean it's something wrong. It just, Angular team has changed the template a little bit, but it's fine. Now let's go back to our command line and stop the server by Control C. And now I can look at the project file. I'm just gonna use an editor, Atom, which is my favorite editor. So I'm just gonna say Atom dot, but if you have another editor, feel free to use it. All right, so I have the project open here. I have main two folder, E2E, which is end-to-end testing, and SRC, so this is my source folder, where all my project files are located, and I have a bunch of configuration files at the root level. So one of the main files I'm interested in is package.json, and this is very important because this is where all the dependency lies. And so the first thing is simple name, version, and script. Remember, we run this ng serve open, so it's here, start. And you can run ng test to run the test. And then you have dependencies. This is where all the Angular package lives. And anything that requires to, as part of the functionality. So you, in order to build your project, you need Angular code. And this is basically all the Angular library that you would need. Dev dependency is not required part of the functionality, but anything that requires for you to develop this project. Angular CLI helps you develop, but it's not part of the functionality that gets delivered, right? Same thing with, there's some Jasmine, which is a testing environment. There's a Karma, and there is a TypeScript. Again, it's all required to when you're building the project, but it's not part of the functionality. And you can look at the configuration into tsconfig file. Here, the main thing you need to notice is target. Target is ES5, which means that I'm gonna write all the code in TypeScript, but it will compile into ES5 version of JavaScript, which is accepted on most browsers. So that's an important thing to know. Now let's go into source folder and look at the main functionality. Now the starting point is nothing but index.html. Inside you have the HTML head and body. And within the body, all you have is this tag called app root. Now in order to understand Angular application, you need to understand components, because the main concept of Angular application is to break down your app into smaller chunks called components. So your main application would be a main component, which is here called app root. And each component will have its own tag, its own template, and its own TypeScript, or called JavaScript, right? And it can have its own CSS as well. And you can have component inside components inside components, to all the way to a level where you have, you know, input boxes and some text. These are the lowest component you would see. So basically, it's a hierarchy of components. So the main component is app root, which is at the top level. So let's look at it. And so if I go inside the app, I have the app component. And the first thing you do is app component.html. So when I run my app, it will take this inside the index.html, wherever I see the app root, it will replace this content with this content of this HTML file, which is app component. And it is because if I look at the app component.ts, it says a selector is app root, which means wherever this app root tag is, replace this with the template that I prefer, which is app component, and apply the style, which is app component CSS. So that's the only thing you need to remember. Now we'll look at, in following tutorials, we'll look at more in detail what the components are, but right now for all you need to know is this. And again, if I go back to the command line and compile the project again by typing ng serve dash dash open, you would see this welcome to app, the logo, and the three links, which is actually inside the app component HTML. If you look at it, it has a title, welcome to app, and it has this logo, and it has these three links. Now here I have welcome to title, and this double curly brackets. This is called string interpolation, which means whatever I have inside my TS, I can access it directly inside my template. So if I look at the TS, I have a title equal to app. So if I change here, instead of app, if I call it my first app and save it, this should be automatically welcome to my first app. If I go back to my browser, as soon as I save it, automatically reloads my app with this welcome to my first app. And I can remove all these three links from here so that it's clean. And as soon as I save it, it will reload the page and the links are gone. So this is quite neat. You don't have to refresh the page and all that stuff. It auto refreshes with the latest information. Now as I said, each component has CSS, HTML, its TS file, and it has something else called app component specs.ts. This is pre-written test for this component. And I'm not gonna too deep into what it is, but what it does is here, if I look at it, it says it should have created the app. So it checks if the app is created. It should have a title called app. Remember, there used to be a title called app. Now we changed it to my first app. So this test should fail because it's trying to compare the title with this hard-coded text called app. So now if I run this test, so on a separate console, I can run the test. So remember, in the package.json, we have a command called ng-test. So this is what I'm going to use. I'm just going to say ng-test. And it builds a test and it will open a browser while it will run all the show the result of the test. All right, as expected, it should fail. So I have one failure. Actually, I have two failures. So the first, it says expected app, but it says my first app. So we can fix it by going in the test, app component spec.ts. And here I can say should have as title my first app. And that's the name of the test. And expect app.title equal to, instead of app, I can say my first app. And as soon as I save it, it will rerun the test. And now I have only one failure. Again, there's somewhere. Oh, okay, the second test, which is here. So the second test is, yeah, it's supposed to check welcome to app. So instead, here it's supposed to say welcome to my first app. And if I save it, it should run it again. And now it's passing all three tests. So tests are very important. If you have a production version of code, you know how important tests are. And again, we'll look at the syntax and everything in detail in subsequent tutorials. The objective of this tutorial is to get started. Okay, so the last step is now let's upload this project on a GitHub site. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to stop the server. If I say git diff, which means it will show me all the changes I've made so far. And as you can see, it will show me that it has, and remember, I remove all the links, and I've changed the tests. And so it will show me all the, and then the title. So before I commit, I need to commit all the changes. So the first command is git status, and it would show me I have changed three files. So I would say git add space dot, which means prepare all these three files for commit. And now if I do get status, all three files should be in green. And now the next thing is prepare for commit. So I would say git commit dash m, and I need to give some instruction what I'm changing. So I would say initial commit. And it has committed. Now I need to push all these changes onto my GitHub. So you need to create a GitHub account. If you don't have it, you need to create one. So I do have a GitHub account, and I'll show you how to do it. So I do have an account called TechSithGit. Since I already have an account, if I go and log in, all I have to do is start a new project. And here I need to create a repository name, so I'm just going to say my first ng is actually app. So the same name as the project that we just created. And I'm not going to put anything else. Do not initialize this repository with README. Just keep it public and click on create. So just name and public. That's all you need to do. And once you create it, it would have a bunch of commands here. And so one of the most important thing is it will give you this. If I want to push an existing repository, I need to use this command, which is git remote add origin. So what it does actually, it will remember this URL where it's supposed to push the project. And the name of this variable is origin. So if I, it's not really pushing, it's just preparing to push. So if I copy this and type it in my console, now it saved this version. So now if I say git remote dash v, it should show me the origin which it already set to that URL. Now I just need to type the second command, which is git push dash u origin master. Now right now it's committing all the pushing all the changes to my GitHub site. But if you're doing it the first time, it should ask you the username and password for the GitHub account that you created. And once you do it first time, it should remember it, and next time you don't have to do it. So now if I come back to my GitHub site and click on here, my first project, I would see all the files uploaded there. And if you want to look at this project, you can go to this site, github.com, techsithgit slash my first ng app, and you'll be able to clone this project and look at it, or just look at it here directly. And all the changes I made here should be here. So this should be your starting point, or just create your own project and upload on your Git. And if you're having trouble, let me know, I can help you. What you also might want to do is, if you go to my profile, add me, you can follow me here so you have a reference, or you can look at my other projects when I upload for the next tutorial. All right, so for the next tutorial, we will start by learning TypeScript. Before we go deep into Angular, we need to know basic TypeScript so we don't get confused when we start building our components. So I hope you learned something from this tutorial, and if you did, please like, subscribe, and provide a constructive comment. Thank you.